Hello students, welcome back to my channel. In this video we will study about Onsager reciprocal relation, or it is also called as simply Onsager relation. Okay, and we know that the phenomenological relation, okay, we know phenomenological relation, okay, that gives the relationship between the flux and flux is directly proportional to the driving force. Okay, phenomenological relation says that the flux is directly proportional to the driving force. Now if I represent flux by the letter J and driving force letter by the X, then this relation is called as phenomenological relation. Okay, now to remove the proportionality sign, I write some constant, say L. Okay, L. Okay, where L means what? It is a constant or coefficient called as phenomenological coefficient. Okay, and this particular relation is termed as the phenomenological relation or equation. Now, one of the example for this, the phenomenological coefficient, is this one. Okay, let me write here. dm divided by dt is equal to d into dc divided by dx. Okay, this is one of the example for the phenomenological relation. Okay, this equation or relation is called as Fick's law. Okay, the Fick's law of diffusion. Okay, this is nothing but what? Fick's law of diffusion. Okay, what is this term representing? This is J. What is L? Coefficient is D. Okay, X is represented by this one, dc by dx. Okay, now we will see what is this term is actually representing. Okay, so this is nothing but dm by dt is nothing but dm by dt means rate of change of solute across the surface. That means if you consider a system, okay, or a chamber, okay, this is two chambers, okay, these are two chambers and this chamber is separated by the wall. Okay, this wall is the what I can say, it is a permeable, okay, this is a permeable membrane. Okay, this is a permeable membrane. Okay, this is one chamber, I call it as one. Okay, first chamber, this is the second chamber, or two vessels that are connected by some permeable wall. Okay, so this membrane will allow the solute present in the chamber one to this component, and similarly this, there will be solute present in this, no, that will this membrane will allow the solute from this to here. Okay, so what this membrane will do? It will allow the flow of solute from the chamber 1 to chamber 2. Also, this will allow the solute to flow from chamber 2 to chamber 1. Okay, now what is dm by dt? dm by dt means the rate of change of solute across the surface. Okay, dc by dx means concentration gradient. Okay, so x is what? Driving force, right? So here driving force is what? Concentration gradient. Okay, d is nothing but a constant, just similar to the L. So here it is diffusion coefficient. Okay, this particular expression is called as what? Fick's law. Okay, Fick's law of diffusion. Okay, now we know that this membrane is allowing the solute to transfer from here to here, as well as solute can transfer from here to here. Correct. So as a result of this, this expression is there, no, that is not sufficient, or this cannot explain this process happening, right? So we have to modify this particular expression. Okay, we will write modified equation. Modified equation. Okay, so why we are considering modified equation? Because this particular, which expression? This particular expression doesn't define the process. Okay, both the process cannot be defined by this particular expression. So we need to modify the expression. Okay, we will see how. Now consider this. Okay, first you consider this. That means the flow of solute from the component 1 to the component 2. So, I call it as dm1 by dt. Okay, what is dm1 by dt? It is for the rate of change of solute. Okay, dm by dt means what? The rate of change of solute that is moving from where? Component 1 to component 2. That is dm1 by dt. Okay, is equal to what? It is equal to some constant, right? So, let me call it as d only. Then, I call it as dc1 by dx. Okay, I am just changing this expression only. Okay, in this one. Plus e into dc2 divided by dx. Okay, why I am writing two terms? Because we know that whenever the solute is going from this component to this component, first what happens? Here the concentration changes, right? So, here the concentration gradient is what? dc1 by dx. Okay. So, dc1 by dx means what? It is the concentration gradient corresponding to the chamber 1 or component 1. Now, the solute is from here. It is moving to here, means once again concentration gradient changes in the chamber 2 also, right? So that is why I am considering E is some constant, okay? dc2 by dx. Hope you are understanding. Now, there is another process, that is I considered only this process now. That is solute is going from this to this chamber. Now, this is also happening, correct? So, for that I am considering dm2 by dt. Okay, what is dm2 by dt? It is for the transfer of the solute from the chamber 2 to the chamber 1. It is given by some constant. I call it as f. Okay, you can write any constant. Okay, nothing to worry about that. So, what happens whenever solute is going from 2 to 1? First, concentration of this changes, correct? Because solute is moving from this to here. Correct? So, as a result, concentration gradient will be there. So, that is what I am writing now, dc2 by dx. Okay, dc2 by dx means what? It is a concentration gradient present here. Okay? Now, the solute is going from here to here. Means here also, once again, concentration changes or solute concentration changes and hence there will be a gradient. Right? So, I call it as G, okay, constant, okay, dc1 by dx, okay, dc1 by dx, okay. Now, these two expressions will represent the whole process, okay. This process is also explained by this expression and this process is explained by this expression, correct. So, hope you are getting to know. Now, what I do is I just call this as J1. Okay, because I already told here, where here dm by dt is representing what? J. D is representing what? Constant called L. And dc by dx is representing what? X. Correct. Now, here this dm1 by dt is there. I am representing that by letter J1. Okay, similarly, I represent this by letter called J2. Okay, now these constants are there, no? D, E, F, G. These are all constant. Okay, let me write here. D, E, F and G. Okay, these four terms are there, no? These are all constant or coefficient. Just similar to your L in the phenomenological relation. Okay, I call it as coefficient or constant, anything. Well, or phenomenological coefficient, whatever. Now, what I do is, I represent these constants by letter L only, okay? Because I said these constants representing what? Letter L in this expression, correct? So, what I am writing is general equation. So, I am representing all these constant or coefficient by the letter L, okay? But, I am writing the numbers here. Where? Here. I am representing this as L11. This as L12, okay, while F I am representing as L22 and G as L21. Okay, why I am representing these by different numbers 1, 1? What does these representing? Now, once again, just see here clearly. What is D here? Tell me. It is a constant, correct? It is nothing but L only. Now, what is this number representing? We already told this particular expression is for what? Is for this particular process. But the photon transfer of solute from this component to this component. Means, first, one is there, no? Here one, okay? This is for DE. Okay, here I can see D and E for the first equation. So, 1, 1 for the first process. Now, here second term you see, 1, 2. What does that represent? Okay, now whenever solute is going from this component to this, first where the concentration gradient will develop? Here, 1 at the first chamber. That is what this one is. Okay, now because of the transfer of solute from here to here, here also concentration gradient changes, right? So, that is why it is 2. Now what is this? Now this is representing which process? This particular process, okay? That is from transfer of solute from the second component to the first component. Means the second component to first component. That is what first number is representing. That is transfer of solute from which component? From the second component. Here transfer of solute is from which component? First component, correct? So, now what is this number 2 representing? Now, whenever solute is moving, first concentration changes here. Because of that, concentration gradient is first developed here, right? Where? Here, sorry. In this component. That is why this is 2. Okay, now then you have 1 because here also concentration. Where? I'm sorry. The here concentration gradient changes, right? So, that is what here 2, 1 representing. Hope it is clear, okay? Now, I am representing this terms, dc1 by dx is there, no? That I represent by x1, okay? Because I already said here, dc by dx is representing what? X. So, I call it as x1, this as x2, here once again these are same, no? So, this is x2 and this is what? My x1, okay? Now, I am writing in the form of letters. Okay, how the equation will look like? Okay, now this term is represented by J1. E is equal to, D is represented by what? L11. Then you have X1 plus E is represented by L12. Correct? Then you have X2. Then here J2 is equal to, F is what? F is my L22. Then you have X2 plus, then G is represented by L21. This is X1, correct? This is in term of what? Letters J and L and X. Okay, now we will write general equation. How will the general equation will look like? Okay, general equation or general expression. Okay, now here I am not writing 1, 2 and all. Instead, I write Ji. Okay, Ji is what? J1, J2, J3, J4, like that. Okay, now then you have L, correct? After J you have L and later you have X. Now, here you see, whenever J is 1 here, L is, first term is always that only. Whenever J is 2, the L first term is what? That only, right? So, I write Li. Okay, then you have x1, x2, x3, something like that, okay? So, Li1 here, okay? Li1, here Li2, correct? This I and this number, okay? This number and this number are all same, correct? Li2 and this is x2. Now, this is only for the 2 component I said. Now, if there are many components, like n components are there, means the expression will look like this. I3, X3 plus etc. The last term will be LILXN. Correct? This is how the expression will look like. Okay. Now, this expression is called as linear phenomenological relation. Okay. Linear phenomenological relation. Okay. LPR. Okay. Linear phenomenological relation. Okay. Now, in this particular linear phenomenological relation, you will come across 2 terms. Okay. You will come across 2 terms. We will see what are the 2 terms. Okay. 2 terms are observed. 2 terms. So, what are the 2 terms is, One is this LII, another one is LIJ. Okay, so here you can see here. Now this is for only two component. Here also you can see two numbers same, that is LII. Here it is LIJ. Correct, means two terms are different. IJ, different letters, no, just similar to that, different numbers. Okay, here it is same number. If you see here, once again these two numbers are same, this is different. So in this expression also you can see two terms. One is where the two numbers are same, where two numbers are different. Okay, now whenever you see LII, means example what, L11, L22, L33, like that. Okay, so whenever you have this, is called as, okay, this particular coefficient is called as primary phenomenological coefficient, primary phenomenological coefficient, where this is called as Onsager phenomenological coefficient. Okay, whenever you have these two terms different, no, means I is different from J, then we call it as Onsager phenomenological coefficient. Okay, in the year of 1931, Onsager proved experiment, theoretically. Okay, Onsager proved theoretically, that is LIJ is equal to LJI. Okay, he proved what? LIJ is equal to LJI. Okay, in this particular relation is called as Onsager relation. Okay, Onsager relation or Onsager reciprocal relation. Okay, LIJ is equal to LJI. It is called as Onsager relation or Onsager reciprocal relation. Okay, this is all about Onsager reciprocal relation. If you have any doubt in this video, please let me know. Thank you for watching.